The task force radioed Sergeant Smith and told him to find a secure spot to hold some Iraqi prisoners. After a quick recon, he found one, an abandoned courtyard. Then he called in an ace so we could breach a hole in the wall and build our holding cage.
Once Sergeant Smith's Hollinshed and Pelletier confirmed the courtyard was clear, Smith sent me and Private Martins to guard the metal gate.
We need to clean out these corners and string up some wire. Let's get moving.
Right, Sergeant.
The courtyard had these walls, about 8 to 10 feet tall. It was a triangular-shaped courtyard, and inside we wanted to string concertina wire across the corner and use it for a holding cage. Now, the far end had a steel gate, and there was a tower outside of the walls on the near side. We were going to use that for guard purposes.
Hey, I see something outside the gate. Sergeant Smith, come look. We got about 15, 20 Iraqis.
Iraqi special forces were pouring out of a barracks building behind the courtyard.
In a matter of minutes, we started taking incoming fire from the small arms and RPGs.
Sergeant Smith, there's more!
Now we saw like 50, and it just escalated to the point that we realized that we were getting swarmed.
Sergeant Smith went over to look. He and some of the other guys threw hand grenades over the wall to take out some of the Iraqis. After that, more RPGs and small arms fire started going on.
Tell the Bradley there's 50 enemies with RPGs! No, it looks more like 100! We're in a world of hurt.
Back outside the courtyard, we were firing on the tower because the Iraqis had taken it.
That's when the Bradley came through. Popped the cup through the gate and drove right over it. Put his vehicle outside the gate the whole way and started shooting.
Sergeant Smith and Keller went outside the gate and started firing.
We couldn't fall back. We had to hold our positions and fight these Iraqis off. There were about 120, 150 Iraqi Special Republican Guards. We were getting ambushed.
The enemy attempted to gain contact with us using some of the terrain that they owned, the tower and the walls. First Sergeant Campbell told me he needed a fire team. I quickly put together two gunners and another rifleman. We approached the tower. When we got to within 25 feet from it, they started opening fire on us.
The front of the tower had a window that was large enough to fire out, but you couldn't get any fire into it. We still had to reinforce the gate. That's when Sergeant Smith radioed to the other side of the compound.
Burwald! Yetter! We need your APC at the gate!
Sergeant Burwald came up in his track and started engaging.
RPGs began bombarding. Mortars began landing 15 meters away. Hill was feeding Sergeant Burwald 50 caliber rounds and continued providing suppressive fire.
Then the track was struck by a mortar.
Medic! Medic! We're hit!
The Bradley was out of ammo and left to get more. The M113 was a critical platform for the 50 cal, and we had lost that weapon. We were down to three or four guys with rifles at that open gate.
We didn't have any kind of infantry support. M113s, Bradleys, none of that. We were in deep trouble.
Sergeant Smith, we gotta kill that tower! We need the APC over there!
Seaman, get me a driver!
I got up in the driver's seat. He sent me backwards and parked me, more to the middle of the courtyard. Told me to keep my head down till he called for ammo.
Whenever you hear the gun go quiet, just feed me another box of ammo. Get those wounded out of here.
Sergeant Smith fired on three positions. One position where Iraqis were coming over a wall. You had the steel gate and they were trying to come through there. And then you had the tower. He'd engage one and then they'd go away. And then he'd go to the next one. That was the only way we could move on the tower, and that was the key.
He knew the 50 cal was the only thing keeping us alive and holding the enemy back. He also knew he had to keep it going no matter what the cost. He didn't care what that was.
He was outnumbered about 100-20, and he didn't stop. He fought back. He was the largest weapon system firing against overwhelming enemy odds. He didn't quit. We couldn't have evacuated the wounded without him. After we had taken the tower, Sergeant Smith's machine gun stopped. I thought he was just reloading his machine gun, but...
Sergeant Smith! Sergeant Smith! He's hit!
Grasp covered sod, his spirit.